The business version of it is, what great company is nobody starting? Mm-hmm. And then the pointed sort of team building version of it, whenever I have a few people who are in the process of starting a company, that I ask is, why will the 20th talented engineer, you know, let's 20th talented person join your company when they can get paid way more at Google? They will have to work way less hard at Google. It will look better on their resume to go to Google. You know, why in the world would they ever join your company? And you know, you can come up with, the monetary answer is generally not a good one, because the monetary answer, you know, that works in a few rare cases, but chances are that you won't at employee 20 have a business that's so robust and doing so well financially that it's a no-brainer to people to join it. Mm-hmm. You know, if you think the equity piece, the sort of, you know, yeah, the equity might be worth more, but it gets diluted. The 20th person doesn't get that much equity as a percentage. Mm-hmm. And so the answers that I think work are that somehow you are in a really unique business. This is the only place in the world where you can work on this incredibly important problem. And that's the kind of answer you want to give. So it doesn't necessarily, you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be, you know, you can sort of debate scale or anything like that, but it has to, on some dimension, be a really important problem that at least some people think is the most important problem in the world. And those are the kinds of businesses that are unique. When they work, they end up being leaders in their respective markets. And that's sort of, I think, the general formula that works. And